This trivia question. What is science fiction hero Buck Rogers' real first name? Well, you get the answer to that question and be challenged by many more on Trivia Trap.
Welcome to the fascinating world of trivia. Our senior team is ready. Playing for the seniors are Mary Howe, Robert Woodyear, and Paula Campbell. And the junior team is set. Playing for our juniors are Jeff Schlosser, Katie Lieber, and Diane Sorensen. And here's the host of Trivia Trap, Mr. Bob Eubanks.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Trivia Trap. We're glad you could join us today. Two new teams? Nope, we got one new team because we have returning champs with us. But first of all, I want you to meet our challengers, all under the age of 30. And they're the juniors, and here they are. Our returning team, the champs, they didn't win the big money yesterday, but boy, would they love to do it today. Welcome our seniors back with us. All right, if you're ready to play our game, we're going to start off with a fact or fiction round. I'll give each one of our contestants a trivia statement. What they must do is tell me whether that statement is true or false. Every correct answer is worth $25 for their team, so let's go to our returning champs. Paula, Robert, and Mary, tell me, would you like to have the red set or the black set of questions?
Red.
Red set. Black set then goes to our juniors, and here we go. Mary, right to you. True or false, there are no clocks in Las Vegas gambling casinos.
That's true.
It sure is true. Right. They don't want you to know what time it is, just how much you got. Robert, a single 75-watt bulb gives more light than three 25-watt bulbs.
That's true.
Yep, you're right. It is true. Good for you. Paula. Olivia de Havilland's real name is Olivia Fontaine.
True.
Nope. However, her sister Joan Fontaine's real name is Joan de Havilland. How about that? Okay, you got two out of the three, right? That's not so bad at all. You got $50. Let's go over to our juniors. Welcome to our show. Nice to have you with us. Jeff, they left you with a black set of questions, and here's your first question. The bumblebee dies when it stings.
True.
No, it's false. They can sting and sting and sting again. All right, Katie. Science fiction hero Buck Rogers' real first name is Anthony.
False.
No, it's true. It's his name. Sorry, Diane. The only state in the Union that has one syllable is Maine.
False.
No, that's true. That's true. It's all right. Lots of time to catch up, believe me. You tell me this time, juniors, red set or black set of
red?
Questions?
Let's go for the red.
Red.
Want the red? Black set then goes to our seniors, and we'll go right back to Diane. True or false, Diane? The music for the classic Marlon Brando movie On the Waterfront was composed by Leonard Bernstein.
False.
No, it's true. It's true. Katie, country music's hottest duo, the Judds, are mother and daughter.
True.
Yeah. Okay, Jeff, the world's oldest surviving parliament is that of Great Britain.
True.
Nope. False. Iceland's assembly is the world's oldest surviving parliament. Okay, let's go back to our seniors, and with this set of questions, Paula, we'll begin with you. If you cut an octopus and it bleeds, its blood will come out blue.
False.
No, it's true. It is true. Robert, it's impossible to sneeze and keep one's eyes open at the same time.
That's true.
It sure is true. You got another 25. All right, Mary. Mary, more women own stock than men.
That's true.
Yes, it is true. Right you are. So there you have it. End of our fact of fiction round. We've got $25 for our juniors, $100 for our seniors. We've got to get to $1,000 eventually. This gives our seniors, by the way, the advantage in our trivia track round, which we will play when we come back right after this. Welcome back to Trivia Trap. $25 for our juniors, $100 for our seniors. It's the team that makes it to $1,000 that wins the game and then goes on to play for a possible $10,000. And seniors, you know, because you're out in front, that gives you the advantage in this round. You get to choose the categories for every question. So the first decision you have to make is between these categories, Paul McCartney or U.S. presidents. What do you think it'll be?
U.S. President.
U.S. President. You were voted down, weren't you, Mary?
No.
Oh, okay. So we'll leave Paul McCartney for our juniors. And the question goes to Mary, first of all. Category is U.S. Presidents. Remember, in this round, the questions are worth either $50, $100, or $200, depending on how many of you agree on the correct answer. Mary, who is the only U.S. President to visit all 50 U.S. states while in office? Was it Richard Nixon,
Lyndon Johnson, Ronald Reagan, or Gerald Ford?
Lyndon Johnson.
You say Lyndon Johnson. Let's find out if Robert agrees or disagrees with that.
I agree.
You agree with Lyndon Johnson. How about you, Paula?
I'm going to disagree.
Disagree, okay. Two of you say that it's Lyndon Johnson. If you're right, it's $100 for your team. Hang on and let's find out. Did Lyndon Johnson visit all 50 states? No, he did not. It wasn't Lyndon Johnson. So, Paula, you can still get $50 for your team if you can find the right answer. Who do you think it is?
I'm going to say Richard Nixon.
Richard Nixon. Well, audience seems to agree with you. Let's find out if you're right. Was it Richard Nixon that visited all 50 states? Salvage $50 out of it. All right, you've now got $150. Let's go down to our juniors who need to do some catching up. And they left you with the category of Paul McCartney. And how happy you were about that, huh? Jeff, question goes to you, as you know. Which of these is the official newsletter of the Paul McCartney fan club? Is it Yesterday's, Wings Wag, Applesauce, or Club Sandwich? The official newsletter of the Paul McCartney Fan Club. What do you think it
is? I'll say Wings Wag.
Wings Wag, you'll say. Katie, what do you think?
I think I'm going to agree with that.
You agree with Wings Wag. Diane.
I'm going to disagree.
You disagree. $100 for your team and a chance to close the gap a little bit. Let's find out. Is the newsletter called Wings Wag? No, it is not Wings Wag. Diane, you can still get $50 for your team if you can find the right answer. What do you want to go with?
I'm going to say Yesterday's.
Yesterday's? Sounds good, doesn't it? $50 for the juniors. Is it Yesterday's? No, it's called Club Sandwich. I don't know. Okay, you still got 25. Let's go back to our seniors and let them choose another category. Barbie doll or Rodgers and Hammerstein this time?
Rodgers and Hammerstein.
Rodgers and Hammerstein. We'll leave Barbie doll down there for the juniors then. Robert, questions to you. Famous composers Richard Rodgers and Oscar Hammerstein collaborated on many Broadway musicals. What was their last musical together? Was it Oklahoma, South Pacific, The Sound of Music, or The King and I?
Sound of Music.
Sound of Music. Paula, agree or disagree?
I agree with that.
You agree. Mary?
I agree too.
You agree too. Well, $200 was the last Rodgers and Hammerstein musical, The Sound of Music. Very good. Oklahoma was in 1943, South Pacific was 49, and The King and I was in 1951. It was The Sound of Music, 1959. You've got $350. Come on, juniors. They left you now with this category, Barbie doll. And Katie, it's for you. In keeping up with the times, what clothing line was recently added to the Barbie doll's wardrobe? Is it Japanese clothes, astronaut clothes, business clothes, or maternity clothes?
I believe it was business clothes.
Business. Let's see. Yeah. Diane agrees with you. We're coming back. Jeff, how about you? Everybody says business? Let's find out. $200 if the correct answer is business clothes. Barbie has business clothes now, and she comes with a briefcase. You can also buy an office playset. Hope you're writing this down. I am. You've got $225, juniors. You've got $350, seniors. Our goal is to get to $1,000. We'll do that. We'll play our trivia race right after this. $225 for our juniors, $350 for our seniors. The goal is to get to $1,000. And the way we get there is by playing our $1,000 trivia race. So if you come with me, the race will begin right now. Trivia race until one of our teams reaches $1,000. The winners will then get a shot at $10,000. And our seniors are out in front. They have $350. That means they get to go first. They'll have three chances to come up with the correct answer to a question. If all three of them miss, control then goes over to the other side. And each question's worth $100. So, Mary, you have the choice to make hit song, Jackie O, or movie. What will
it
be?
Let's go with movies, Jack.
I'm Bob.
Sorry about that.
That's all right. Just don't put too many O's in it, all right? Here we go. What was the last major silent film made in Hollywood?
The Great Train.
Robert.
The Great Dictator.
Incorrect. Paula.
The Great Train Robbery.
I'm sorry, no. A movie called Silent Movie, made in 1976 by Mel Brooks. You're frozen at $350. Let's go to the juniors with $225 and Jeff.
Oz.
Juniors, what's the Tin Woodman's first word in The Wizard of Oz?
Oil.
Yes, they're right, oil. Katie.
Hit song.
Tell me, Katie, in 1975, Love Will Keep Us Together was the first hit for what musical duo?
The Captain and Tennille.
You did it, Captain and Tennille. Diane.
Jackie O.
Jackie O. Here it is. What's the name of the Greek island on which Jackie Kennedy and Aristotle Onassis were married?
Monaco.
No, I'm sorry, Jeff.
Crete.
Incorrect. Katie.
Oh.
Scorpios. You're frozen at 425. Back to the seniors and Mary.
Singer.
Singer, all right. Who is the lead singer of The Doors?
Oh, forget it.
No, Robert?
Jim Morrison.
Yes, it was Jim Morrison. I'm not sure you know that one, Mary. Paula?
General.
Excuse me, Paula.
General.
General. Okay. What general defeated Robert E. Lee at Gettysburg? Don't, Mary?
Grant.
Incorrect, Robert.
Meade.
Yes, George Meade, you're right. Good for you. Very good. Paula again.
Country music.
All right. Paula, Coal Miner's Daughter was the story of country music superstar Loretta Lynn. Who played Loretta in the movie?
Sissy Spacek.
That's right. Sissy Spacek. Doing fine. Here we go, Mary.
Try swan.
Tell me, Mary, a male goose is a gander. What's a male swan? Robert?
Drake.
No, Paula.
I was going to say Drake.
No, correct. A cob. C-O-B. It's what you call a male swan. You're frozen at 650 to the juniors and Diane.
Rock groups.
Rock group. All right, juniors, time to do some catching up. What rock group gave us the famous album Sticky Fingers?
Grateful Dead.
No.
Rolling Stones.
Yes, Rolling Stones. Katie.
Jingle Freak.
Katie, what is the name of the product that uses the tune Pearly Shells on their commercials? Diane.
Pearl Drops?
No, Jeff.
Dove.
Don't know. C&H Sugar. You're frozen at 525. That was the 10th question. Hereafter, values double. They're now worth $200 apiece. Juniors have 525. Seniors have 650. Here we go, Mary.
Award.
Award it is. The U.S. has its Oscar. What does Canada call its awards for motion picture excellence?
Grant.
Robert.
Benji.
No, Paula.
Cleo.
No, it's the genie. You're frozen at 650. Back to the juniors with Katie.
Transvestites.
In the 1959 movie, Some Like It Hot, two men dressed up as women in an all-girl band. Jack Lemmon played one of them. Who played the other?
Tony Curtis.
That's right, Tony Curtis. Juniors are taking the lead, Diane.
Candy.
Candy. Before they became multi-flavored, what was the first flavor of Lifesavers?
Cherry.
No.
Peppermint.
Peppermint is right, yes. Katie.
Country music, please.
For the game and the chance to play for $10,000. Name the country superstar whose hits include Dang Me, Chug-a-Lug, and Doo-Wack-a-Doo.
Merle Haggard.
No.
Roger
Diane.
Miller.
Roger Miller! Gonna do it today. Didn't do it. End up with $650. And thank you, Mary. Nice to have you with us on our show. Very best of luck to you. Thank you, Robert. You know a lot of trivia, though, I'll tell you that. Paula, nice to have you with us. Thank you a lot. Well, look here, champs. You've got $1,125 right there, but that is nothing compared to what's about to happen to you. Because as you know, in a moment, we're going to begin our climb up our trivia ladder. At the top of that ladder is a pot of gold of $10,000. You come right back with us, and we'll begin that climb. All right, we have new champions, and let's get them in here right now. Come in here, juniors. You did a fine job. Oh, congratulations, Sue. You were really down at one time. You guys had like $207. They had $650, and then bam, 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 bam. It was great. You did a wonderful job. You're the champs, and now we're going to give you an opportunity to win $10,000. I would love to see you do it. I want you to go over there and get in position and good luck to you. started as partners, but now you're on your own. And your positions over there have been determined by how well each of you did in our trivia race. Jeff, you did best, so you're in the number one spot. That gives you the option, Jeffrey, to either play or pass on our first set of answers. We're going to climb up our ladder, rung by rung, until you get to the top. And at the top, as you know, is a pot of gold of $10,000. So if you're ready, hang on. Here we go. This is going to be a very exciting climb toward that big pot of gold. The Brothers Grimm, Hans Christian Andersen, Mother Goose, Aesop. Jeff, you want to play or pass?
I'll play.
Gonna play. Question is worth $1,000 to you, but most important of all, a chance to play for the big pot of gold up at the top of our ladder. Here's your question. In whose writings will you find the story of the ugly duckling?
Hans Christian Andersen.
Hans Christian Andersen, you said. Good luck to you. Please let it be, huh? For $1,000, is it Hans Christian Andersen? Congratulations to you. You've got $1,000, and better yet, you'll play for the big money. Let's find out right now if the ladies are going to join you. Hang on, Katie and Diane. Let's go to the next level of our ladder. And Katie, this time it'll be your turn to choose whether to play or pass. Gamma globulin, platelets, hemoglobin, plasma. What do you think? Play or pass?
I think I'm going to pass.
Pass those to Diane. Diane, the question is yours, and here we go. What gives blood its red color? What gives blood its red color?
Plasma.
Plasma. Oh, let's find out. For Diane, a chance to play at the top of the ladder, is it plasma? No, I'm sorry, it's not. It's hemoglobin. Doggone. We say goodbye to you, Diane. Thank you very much for being with us today. Okay, Katie, you passed that time. Can't pass this time. Got to go with the next group. So let's climb to our next level of our ladder. Here we go. TWA, Eastern, American, United. The question. What airline slogan is doing what we do best?
American Airlines.
American Airlines. Come on, Katie, let's find out. Is it American Airlines? All right. Congratulations to you both. I've earned the right to play for the big dollars now. You each have $1,000. And if you're ready, let's go to the top of our ladder. And there's a big pot of gold for you. Here we go. John Lennon, Paul McCartney, George Harrison, Ringo Starr. Here's your question. Who is the only member of the Beatles to have sung on the group's ballad, Yesterday? The only member of the Beatles to have sung on the group's ballad, Yesterday. If you would, please raise the covers in front of you and record your choice. Locked in your answers? What'd you say, Jeff?
I said Paul McCartney.
Okay, Katie, what'd you say? You both said Paul McCartney. If you're right, you're going to split $10,000. Good luck to you. For $10,000 for Jeff and Katie, is it Paul McCartney? Well, not bad, you guys. You end up with $13,125. I want you to keep that as a souvenir. I'd like to say that we'll see them back next time, but we're not going to do that. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our last show on Trivia Trap. And so I would just simply like to say that to Mark Goodson, it took me almost 20 years to be able to work for your company, and I want you to know that I feel that you're a man of class, and everybody around you carries that same kind of class. Thank you, Mark Goodson. To Jonathan Goodson, who has been a friend and a supporter and a helper and producer of our show. To Mark Breslow, who I can only say he is the best, our director. To Bob Hilton, who helps me through my corny jokes while we're in commercials. Thank you, Bob. Chester Feldman, who nursed me along on this show. And Chester, you're my mentor. Thank you so very much. To Julie Becker, who has been just incalculable with her help. To the entire production staff of Goodson Todman. I love all of you very much. And of course, to my friends at ABC, to the programming department, to the crew and everybody. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We don't say goodbye in this business. We only say until we see you next time. So I'm Bob Eubanks. Until we see you next time. Bye-bye.
It's America's favorite ball game. Bingo! Bingo America with Patrick Duffy, where the world's biggest bingo machine lets you play along with the contestants for a chance to win some money.
I want you to play and I want you to win big.
Download your card for free at GSN.com. And if your bingo matches our bingo, you can win cash.
B-I-N-G-O.
It's that simple.
Watch and play Bingo America tomorrow night at 7, 6 Central, only on GSN.
We've searched the world for ordinary people who claim they can do extraordinary things. From the outrageous, thrilling, and bizarre, to the ridiculous and unbelievable, can they do it? And can our panel of celebrities predict the outcome? Find out now on Wanna Bet. And now, all the way from England, your hosts, please welcome Ant and Dex.
Hello, I'm Ant.
And I'm Dex, and welcome to Wanna Bet, the show where ordinary people come to claim they can do extraordinary things.
But of course, with the pressure of the audience, the cameras and the hot lights, things can go wrong, and people can make mistakes.
That's right. But give us a break, we're doing our best.
Yeah,
all right.
Joining us tonight and ready to bet real money on whether or not our challengers will succeed or fail are four of the finest minds in the whole of this studio. Let's say hello to our celebrity panel. First up, an actor and comedian with his own radio show, The Harland Highway, Harland Williams.
Next up, from movies, TV, and her comedy DVD, No Refund, No Exchange, it's Sherry Shepherd.
Hi, Sherry. Next up, he's a Star Trek legend, Mr. George Takei.
And finally, from TomGreen.com, it can only be Tom Green.
Oh, yeah, that's me. Oh, that's me. I'm from TomGreen.com. Yeah, how are you?
Welcome, Tom.
Hey.
Welcome to the show, guys, all four of you, and the very best of luck tonight. Now, guys, each of you starts with $25,000 to bet any way you want. The celebrity who ends up with the most money tonight will take that amount away for their chosen charity.
So let's bring on our first challenger of the evening. From San Francisco, Paul Dizzy Hips Blair.